I am going to start with the retirement of Brooks Orpik because he has had a heck of a career.
Yep.
Won Stanley Cups in both Pittsburgh and Washington, and he found a way. As the league continued to get faster, he got to be a smarter player, and it was harder for guys who didn't skate quite as well, and he found a way to be really an effective player right till the end. And, you know, he signed that contract with the Washington Capitals. It was a big contract. I was among those who were really skeptical. Why would you sign him for that long? It turned out to be a really good signing for the Washington Capitals in the end, that he was able to mentor some of those other defensemen back there. So for Brooks Orpik, you see the numbers there. Good American boy, as we like to say, and a terrific job to play that long in that many games. Johnny, you know what it's like. You did it. To play
and a winner
in the league
at all levels. And that style. He's a physical guy.
Yeah.
And he was one of those guys, though, you didn't like to play against him. And it almost, you disliked him almost on a personal level because he was chippy and he had big hits and a little edge to his game. And then when you kind of meet him or hear people that know him talk about him, like John Carlson, it almost pains you to acknowledge, apparently he's a great guy. And he's a great teammate. And guys love him. And he's a leader. And he leads by example. And he's supportive and all those different things. I'd rather him just be the jerk I thought he was because he was so hard to play against. And he was a guy, especially early on in his career, you had to know where he was on the ice. He would catch you with your head down, and he would finish it and finish you hard. Was around the gray area sometimes, but that's what he had to do to be successful in NHL career. Congratulations. A really great
terrific
NHL career, and so much fun for him that he ended it with the win late with Washington as well.